Fair tests and comparative tests are really similar types of inquiry. They've got lots in common, but there are some significant differences. The things that they've got in common is both types of inquiry involve one variable being changed, another being measured, and other variables being kept the same so they don't affect your findings. But the big difference is that the data you generate from a comparative test would lead to a bar chart, whereas the data you get from a fair test would always lean towards a scatter or line graph. Examples of big questions for a comparative test are: which material is best at blocking UV light? Which magnet is the strongest? Or which soil is best at holding on to water? These all involve children keeping a number of variables the same, their control variables. There is one variable that they change. For example, the type of magnet or the material. And then you're measuring a feature of that material. The kinds of big questions that you can answer using a fair test are: how does the amount of water affect how much salt can dissolve? How does increasing the voltage in a circuit affect the brightness of a lamp or a volume of the buzzer? Or how does the length of a paper rocket affect how far or how high it will travel? In each case here, you have one variable that you change, your independent variable, one variable that you measure, your dependent variable, and a number of other variables that will be controlled and kept the same so they don't affect your results. Comparative and fair tests are a great opportunity for children to work on their measuring skills. They'll be looking at how to measure accurately, and as they get older, using more and more accurate and complicated equipment. As we help support them in becoming better scientists, we'll be teaching children to repeat their measurements to check that they're reliable and that their experiment is repeatable. When reporting their findings from comparative tests and fair tests, children will be able to get experience in doing more formal reporting with subtitles, and also to include lots of detail in their writing so that somebody reading their method, for example, could follow the instructions and repeat their experiment. We try to encourage lots of detail going into our conclusions as part of the report, where children start by making their point, what is their answer to the big question, but then go on to describe what evidence they've got to support that. Children follow the PEE model. And as they move into year 5 and 6, we try and develop those into paragraphs. So for P, the children would write a whole paragraph making their point, what is their answer to the big question. In their second paragraph, their E paragraph, they'll describe all the evidence that they have got to support that conclusion, referring to graphs, tables, and any calculations that they've made. And finally, using scientific ideas to explain what they've found out, demonstrating their own understanding, and being really clear on what they've discovered through the inquiry.